Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2307, Entering Dynamic Array Formulas with VBA. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I got a quick one, but an important one here today. So, you know, the new dynamic array formulas, filter, sort, unique, sequence. I want 8 rows, 3 columns, starting at 5, jumping by 17. You know, generates that array on the fly. So, you would think that you should be able to use VBA to do that. So Alt F11 to switch over to VBA. Simple little one-line macro here. Range F2 formula is the same formula I just entered. Let's run that. And we'll switch back to Excel. And what the heck? The formula's there, but somehow there's an at sign. I didn't put the at sign there. That's the new dynamic array way to say single, that we just want a single value here. You know, and it's certainly not in the VBA. I didn't put the at sign there. Excel's doing that. And they're doing this for backwards compatibility. If you had a formula that today all of a sudden becomes an array formula and you weren't expecting it to become an array formula, you know, they wrap it in the at sign. So, the easy way to solve this problem, instead of formula, use formula 2. Formula 2 is a method that says we're going to allow dynamic arrays. So, back here, Alt F8. Test dynamic arrays, run, and bam, the formula's there, no at sign, and it works. All right, simple. Once you know it, until you know it though, it will drive you crazy. That is one of the updates in the second edition of Excel Dynamic Arrays book. I know a lot of you downloaded this, the original version, for free. It's now out there on my site for $3. Click the I in the top right-hand corner. And hey, if you like these tips, please, down below the video, click subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments in the comments below. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.